Welcome back to your free Windows 7 training. In this video, I will look at how to configure printers in Windows 7 and also a new feature in Windows 7 called Network Awareness Printing. Like a lot of the services the IT department offers, printing is one that, when down, the end users will be quick to tell you about and demand to be fixed. With Windows, there are three basic print permissions that determine what you can and cannot do with a printer. The first is the print permission. The print permission allows you to print, delete, reorder, and restart your own print jobs. It does not allow you to make any changes or modify any other user's print jobs. The next print permission is manage documents. Manage documents essentially allows you to control any print jobs on the printer for any user. You can pause, restart, cancel, and reorder any job in the print queue regardless of who owns the print job. If you want to make changes to the printer, you need the final permission, Manage Printer. This gives you control over the printer itself, not just the jobs. With the Manage Printer permission, you can pause and restart the printer. You can also change the permissions on the printer, share the printer, and change the properties of the printer. From my Windows 7 computer, I will first open the control panel and then select View Devices and Printers. This screen will show you all the devices and printers installed on your computer. Microsoft in Windows 7 has grouped printers and devices together. The printers I have already installed are at the bottom. If I want to add a new printer, all I need to do is select the option at the top, Add a Printer. Note on this screen, I have the option to add a network printer or a local printer. In this case, I will select Add a Local Printer. When you add a local printer, what you are doing is installing the software to manage that printer on your local computer. This does not mean the printer itself has to be physically connected to the computer. If I select the Ports pull-down, you can see there are numerous different physical ways I could connect this printer to this computer. If I select the option Create a New Port, I can select Standard TCP/IP Port, which allows me to print to the printer over the network. The software is still installed locally on the computer, and the printer is still managed from this computer. What is different is instead of the commands traveling over a cable, such as a USB cable, to the printer, they are instead traveling over the network. On the next screen, I need to enter in the IP address of the printer. Once entered, Windows will now attempt to connect to the printer and attempt to determine the properties of it. In this case, Windows was not able to detect the type of network card in the printer. There is a long list of network cards. If you are not sure which network card to use, select the generic network card, which usually works quite well. Windows will again attempt to detect the types of drivers the printer requires. In this case, Windows was not able to detect the type of printer, but I can go through the list and select the driver needed for this printer. If your printer is not listed, you can always press the button Windows Update to check online for a printer driver. If this fails, you will need to download the driver from the manufacturer's website or use the driver disk that came with the printer. Once you have the driver, press the Have Disk button and browse to the location of the driver. Some printers come with special setup programs for the printer. These are common with DeskJet-style printers. Refer to the instructions that came with your printer for more options. In some cases, the only way to get your printer to work is to use the setup program that came with the printer. This is normally because the setup program will create special ports that are not included by default in Windows. On the next screen, you need to enter in the name of the printer. In this case, I will accept the default name, and the printer will now be installed. Once the printer is installed, I will get an option asking me to share the printer. In this case, I will select No because I want to show you how to manually share the printer later. That's it. Once I press Finish, my new printer will be set up. To configure the printer, right-click on the printer and select Printer Properties. On the General screen, you can see a general rundown of the features of the printer. I like to add the location and comment fields. When you have multiple printers, it makes it easy to tell which printer is which, especially when there are a number of different printers on the network. Down at the bottom, you can see that Letter is available on this printer. This printer has an extra tray for faxes, which I will use yellow A4 paper in. To add this paper size, select Device Settings, and then select the tray you want and select A4. There are a lot of options on this screen, but most of these you will not need to change unless you are troubleshooting an unusual problem. If I go back to the general screen and press Apply, the new A4 paper size will be added. If I want to share the printer, I can select the tab Sharing. Once I tick the tick box Share this printer, the printer will be shared. On a lot of networks, you will see the share name based on the type and brand of the printer. On large networks, I like to change this to something more meaningful for the end user. Something simple like Main Office Level 1 West Printer, I think, is easier to understand than HP LaserJet 4100 Series PCL6. Also, in my experience, printers do get replaced from time to time. If this were to occur, it is unlikely the new printer will be the same brand and model as the last one. This means that everyone using the printer will need to reinstall the printer or use the old share name that is not relevant for the new printer. Setting the printer name to the location of the printer will mean if the printer is replaced, you won't need to change the share name. The option below the share name, Render Print Jobs on Client Computers, means that when the job is being rendered or being converted to an output the printer can understand, this action will be performed on the client computer. If you clear this checkbox, then the job will be rendered on this computer. This means more processing load on this computer and also more disk space to store the jobs while they are being processed. In most cases, you would want to leave this ticked. The only time I can think of that you would want to untick this box is when you have clients using the printer that have very low specs. Down at the bottom of the screen, you have the option Additional Drivers. When this printer is added by another computer, the computer has the option to download the driver for the printer from this computer. In this case, the 64-bit drivers are installed. If I select the 32-bit option, I will be asked for the driver's disk. If I do not install the drivers here, any 32-bit client that uses this printer will need to download the driver themselves for the printer if they do not already have the driver pre-installed on their computer. On the Ports tab, you can change which port the printer is being used on. If a printer were to fail, one trick I like to do on large networks is to change the port to another printer on the network. Assuming the printer drivers are compatible, the print jobs will be redirected to this printer while the first printer is being fixed. On the Advanced tab, you can select a number of different options. The first option you can set is when the printer is available. Below this, you can also set the priority. If you want to use these features, what you would normally do is create multiple printer queues for the same printer. The users that you want to give different priority to or limit which times they can access the printer, you would give access to that particular printer queue. Anyone you don't want to restrict or give different options to, you would give them access to the second printer queue. The options below this determines the spooler setting for the printer. If you often have large documents or documents that take a long time to spool, you may want to select the option Start Printing After Last Page is Spooled. Selecting this option will mean the printer will not print a single page until the job has been transferred to the spooler. Imagine this. You print a 50-page book on a high-speed printer. The job takes 10 minutes to spool because it has a lot of graphics in it, meaning no one can use the printer for 10 minutes. The printer itself can print close to 100 pages a minute, meaning it would easily print the job in less than a minute. If you have this occurring a lot, then you should enable this option. If your printer is printing a lot of small jobs, select the option Start Printing Immediately. This option will ensure the printer is printing pages as fast as it is getting them. The last option prints to the printer directly. This effectively means the computer is bypassed completely. This means the job will not be stored temporarily on the computer, saving you disk space, but also means you have less control over the jobs being printed on the printer. The option Hold Mismatched Documents will hold documents that have been sent to the printer that do not match the printer setup. For example, have the wrong paper size. You would select this option if you change paper sizes or form sizes a lot and want the jobs to wait until the change was made on the printer. For example, maybe you have only one tray in a printer. When A3 paper is in the printer, you don't want to print A4 documents on A3 paper. Once all the A3 jobs are complete, you insert A4 paper into the tray, and the waiting jobs will be printed on A4. Any A3 documents will be held until A3 paper is available again. The option Print Spooled Documents First means that any documents that have fully spooled will be printed first. This is generally a good option to leave on, as it will speed up the number of jobs that a printer can print. The downside of this option is jobs may not be printed in the order they are received. The option Keep Printed Documents will save any documents printed on the printer. This option will quickly eat up your hard drive space on a heavily utilized printer. This option is mainly used for auditing what jobs are printed. The option Enable Advanced Printing Features allows features such as duplex and booklet printing. It also changes the print format to a more advanced format. If you are having compatibility problems, you may want to switch this option off. On the Security tab, you can determine who can access the printer and manage documents on the printer. By default, everyone has access to print to the printer. If you want to stop certain users from printing to the printer, you may be tempted to select the option Deny. This will not only stop everyone printing to the printer, but it will also stop you from printing to the printer. Deny permissions should be used only as a last resort. If you want to stop everyone from printing to the printer, simply clear the Allow checkbox. This will remove everyone's access. Now the only people that can print to the printer are the two administrators or anyone else you choose to add. This demonstrates a local printer, but on an enterprise network, you are more likely going to connect to a print server in order to perform printing. To add a network printer, select the option Add Printer, and this time select the option at the bottom, Add a Network, Wireless, or Bluetooth Printer. Windows will automatically detect any printers on the network. In this case, it has found the printer I want installed on DC1. Once I select it and press Next, it will be installed. There is also a second way I like to install network printers. If I delete this printer, I can also install it by going to the Start menu and entering in \\ and the server name. This will show all the shares and printers that are available on that server. To install a printer from that server, all I need to do now is double-click it. This covers the basics of installing a printer on your computer and also sharing and connecting to other shared printers on the network. The next feature I want to look at is Location Awareness Printing. Location Aware Printing will automatically change the default printer when you change networks. If you regularly change networks, this is a great feature to take advantage of. This feature may also save you from accidentally printing something out to the wrong printer. Location-aware printing is a new feature of Windows 7. In order to take advantage of this feature, you need to be running Windows 7 Professional Edition or above. Also, it is only available according to Microsoft for devices that have a battery, which basically means laptops. In order to demonstrate location-aware printing, I will now switch to my Windows 7 computer. To configure location-aware printing, first select View Devices and Printers from the Start menu. From here, I can see all the printers that are currently installed on this computer. The Canon inkjet printer shown here is the printer I use at home when connected to my home wireless network. The HP OfficeJet printer is the printer that I use when connected to the office network. To configure the default printer used according to the network you are connected to, select the option at the top, Manage Default Printers. This option will only be available if Windows detects a battery in the computer. If you are using a desktop computer, for example, this option will not be present. In the Manage Default Printers, the HP Office DeskJet has already been added as the default printer for my office network. To add a printer for my wireless network, I need to select the wireless network at the top, and then select the printer that will be the default printer for that network. Once I have configured the printers, I can exit this screen, and Windows will now change the default printer according to the network I'm connected to. To demonstrate, this laptop has a switch on the side to enable the wireless adapter. Once enabled, in the sys tray, my home wireless network will appear as being connected. Going to the printers, the default printer has automatically changed to the Canon inkjet printer. Windows 7 detected that the network this laptop was connected to changed and changed the default printer accordingly. Location-aware printing is as easy as that to set up and use in Windows 7. In the next video, I will look at configuring file and folder access using NTFS permissions. For more videos in this free course, please have a look at our website or our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.